Today we're going to talk about ab wheels, who they're good for, what they do, and how to use them. Now, if you turn on the TV at any time of the day or night, you're going to see all these advertisements for revolutionary ab devices that are guaranteed to give you washboard abs in 3 minutes or 3 weeks or whatever the case is. Complete waste of money. Seriously, for 95% of you, abs are made in the kitchen, not the gym. You've already got the washboard abs. They're just covered with a layer of fat that's under the skin. To expose those abs, all you have got to do is eat at a caloric deficit, which means you either need to eat a little less or do a little more exercise. That's not to say, however, that doing core exercise is not important. It's really important. Almost every sport, from boxing to golf, uses the core as the primary driving power in the movement. Also, even more important, in everyday life, a strong core keeps you from getting lower back injuries by having this corset of steel that protects you. The best place to start is my rotisserie core workout. It provides a great strengthening routine for anyone, and it's easy to incorporate in your workouts. You can do it every day or just when you work out, doesn't matter. So start with the rotisserie core workout. Now, having said that, there's some inexpensive ab devices like this ab wheel that can take your core strength and abs to the next level. Now, fancy isn't better on these. They sell some really expensive, wacky ones that don't do anything more than this inexpensive device do. This is like 10 bucks. Let me show you some of the features of a good ab wheel. First of all, a metal shaft. You can't see it, but there's a metal shaft under these rubber grips. A wide wheel. If it's a narrow wheel, it's gonna make trenches in your carpet or make marks in a hardwood floor. So you want a nice wide wheel like this. Also, you want a large diameter wheel. The little like roller skate wheels, again, are gonna make grooves in your carpet or in your floor. So big wheel, metal shaft, wide wheel. Again, don't spend more than 10 bucks on this. As a matter of fact, you can make your own. If you just use a spin lock dumbbell like this, put two collars back to back so that they're firm, and then use just a rotating plate. Then you grab on each hand and use this as your ab wheel. You know, don't buy stuff you don't need to. Okay, now let's talk about how to use this puppy. First of all, you see it advertised with people doing it from their toes. That's really, really difficult. I can't do that. Do it from your knees to start out with. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna put our knees on a really thick pillow. Not a fluffy, like down pillow like for your bed, but a really firm pillow like is on your sofa. Because we wanna protect your knees. This will destroy your knees if you do it on a hard surface. So put your knees on a pillow, and then you're gonna grab the shaft. A lot of these have such small grips that you're gonna hurt your hands. So I would wear a pair of garden gloves. You don't need lifting gloves. Use garden gloves, seriously. Make a fashion statement. So you're gonna grab this, and you're gonna roll out. Now, the mistake a lot of people make is they move too many things at once. The only thing that's moving is your shoulders. Your shoulders are going up, like that. You're not moving your elbows. You're not pivoting at your hip. It's all in the shoulders. So choose a hip angle and hold it. Your arms are straight but not locked, and go out. Only go as far as you can. It takes a long time before you get to the point where you can actually go till your nose touches the ground. Don't feel you have to do that. Go as far as you can and then come back. And then try to do, you know, at least 10 reps. And go go the right distance out so that you can only go about 10 reps. Okay, now let's talk about how to incorporate the ab wheel into your workouts. Now, I'm going to give it for beginner, intermediate, advanced. So, a beginner is someone, in my book, who can't do one pull-up. If you can't do one pull-up, then I would do my rotisserie core workout, and that's it. I would not do the ab wheel. The rotisserie core workout is all you need. If you can do 2 to 8 pull-ups, then what I would do is my rotisserie core workout plus the ab wheel. That's a great combination. And I would do that whenever you work out, do your weight workout. So that might be, 3 to 4 times a week you'll be doing a rotisserie plus the ab wheel. Now, if you're an advanced bodybuilder, someone who can do like a lot more than 8 pull-ups, then you're pretty much well beyond the rotisserie core workout. You're probably doing squats and deadlifts and have a pretty strong core, but what you're lacking at that point is the ability to do asymmetrical stuff. You have a really strong core, but not one that's going to help you twist in motions like golf or boxing and help you in everyday life from getting injured when you do those sudden movements like that. So for an advanced person, what I would do is more things like the one-handed incline press for chest, for example. That's an incredible core workout. Windshield wipers, like TRX stair climbers, piked push-ups, things like that. So it's a little different depending on what level you are. Now let me cover again the form of the ab wheel. So don't make it any more difficult than you can handle. Start with your knees is what I recommend. Remember, the only thing moving is your shoulders. Your elbows are not rotating, your hip is not rotating. It's only your shoulders that are rotating. Go down slow as far as you can, and then go back up. You don't have to go till your nose touches the floor if you can't do that. So just go as far as you can, come back up. Nice slow motion. That's it, the ab wheel. A great little cheap device to take your abs to the next level. Bis nächste Woche, meine Freunde. Auf Wiedersehen.